A member representing Sapele local government in the Delta State House of Assembly, Honorable Chief Felix Anirah, has reacted to the ongoing tussle in whom Sapele should project for the zoned Delta State PDP chairmanship role. As earlier outlined in our series on the issue, the two top contenders happen to be incumbent state chairman, Barrister Kingsley Esiso, and former Sapele local government chair, Honorable Godwin Atose. Chief Felix Anirah spoke to Rero TV on our series to get his take on the matter. Happy viewing.
First and foremost, as far as I'm concerned, and as far as the party is concerned, we have only one candidate for affirmation. The zoning started from Asaba to the 3 senatorial district. And naturally, as a state chairman, past governors, deputy governors, prominent party leaders, either in the Senate or the House of Rep, they are automatic members of the state caucus. And from that particular caucus meeting, the meeting was slated for Delta Central to zone the positions, which was done on the 19th of March in Chief James Iberi's house, where all leaders of Delta Central were invited. In the case of Sapele, I stood as the representative in the caucus, Professor Uriah for Ope, Bernard Odewo for Ethiopia, Sakra, Dr. Sakra for Udu, Oguma for Ugeli South, Majebite for Ugeli North, and of course I'm ready for Ethiopia. We went into the into that caucus meeting, and the chairmanship was zoned to Sapele. It was not zoned to a specific person, it was zoned to Sapele. And when that happened, a few days after that, we called for a meeting because we were required to submit the names before on the 22nd. We called for that meeting. We expected any interested party to come. We had about 60 people in that meeting. After discussion, we had the simple question, whoever is interested in the chairmanship should so indicate. And it was only Godwin Atose who indicated of all the people who were there. So we forwarded his name. I'm not aware if there's any other candidate.
Chief was Barrister Esiso in that meeting.
He refused to come. After all, the one in the Boris place, he refused to come. He's in his character. He feels that he plays God. He refused to show up. As a state chairman, automatically you are a member of any caucus at your senatorial level or your local government level. But he refused to come. I was in Ogara. He refused to come. We called him in Sapele. He refused to come. He has no basis to blame anybody. Did he consult any person that he wants to be state chairman? He did not. Up to this minute as I speak, I'm not even aware. So I don't know if you can just imagine that he's going to be state chairman. But it's not done like that. Politics, you have to consult him. You have to appeal to their conscience to support him. But when you fail, it means you have automatically excluded yourself. It's not a quarrel between anybody. He shut himself out without boasting and a rich man. I'm not talking of being a rich man of 20 whatever. If he says he paid, how much did he pay? How much did he pay? They claim they contributed 24 point something million by the total calculation. At the end of the day, the money was handed over to a Yemi Dejo. A Yemi Dejo said, they gave him only 15 point something million. So where did 9 million go to? Those are what they claim they contributed. So where are the promises they made? We had to pay money between myself and Emily. It was impossible to call other people because it was a day to the election. We had to cough up extra money to take care of other things. Whereas they claimed that they had taken care of those things. So, well, it is not my business to say whether you contributed or not. By simple calculation, if you told me that the total we collected was about 25 point something million, and we ended up handing over 15 million, 15 point something million, then it means there's something wrong somewhere. All those they claimed that they gave money to, they said they didn't give them anything. So how do you want to make me believe that he paid what he was supposed to? You are the only person who collected the money. You are the only person who spent the money without making reference to anybody. So all those garbage that he spent money, he didn't spend money for me in the first place. He's spending that money, if he did at all, to regain his position. So if he says he spent money, I don't know where he spent money. I'm telling you clear. People who campaign with me will tell you clearly how money was spent. And they all ran away after a presidential election. Did we see any of them? They refused to campaign with us. They'll go to a suburban post that they deliver the government. So I have nothing to do with all of that. I have a very simple heart. The election is come and gone, and I don't think I have any reason to undo anybody. The election is arrogance trusting what is happening now. Very arrogant. He feels he's on top, nobody should talk to him. That's where he is. Even when the thing happened, we were trying to call him. He bluffed everybody that said there's only one form, and that the form is with him. You will see how the person will go anywhere. He said, okay. So you have this only form, fill the form and submit now. We don't have problem. You see, nobody plays God. People, when the governor was to contest his second term, he came to this house. He came here. He consulted people. Why do you think you are so arrogant, full of yourself, you don't think you can talk to anybody? Because he pleased people by saying that he's governor's candidate. So all of that, you see, I have nothing against him. But he should learn to change his attitude in life. He should learn to change his attitude in life. You don't look down on people. Don't look down on people. You divide and rule. When it favors you threaten members of the party because you want something. I think those are some of the problems he had with me. He feels he cannot control it. In the first place, you don't force people to respect you. You earn respect. So if you say I'm trying to undo him, that is not correct. I didn't ask him to be arrogant to other people. And I have nothing against him. He used to be, I don't know, he used to be a very good poet, but suddenly he's gotten so swollen-headed. But that's his purpose. If you don't want to be insulted, don't play politics. So nothing will tell on anybody, except a new fight in politics. As far as I'm concerned, they are ready to say unimaginable, unprintable things about you. As a politician, you must accept it. So that has nothing to do.
For me, that?
No, the party will decide. We want to know if you are not trained and say you want to force yourself into a football game, can you perform it? You don't want to train and you want to be a good footballer, is it possible? The party will decide. He did not submit form. He did not subject himself to screening. So, that is it.